The standard deviation chart, or sigma chart, is the third control chart that makes use of fixed sampling. In this case, we're going to take the sigma, so the variation, the variance of the sample, given a number of observation. The standard deviation chart, or sigma chart, is really similar to the R chart in trying to estimate the variability of the process. The problem with the R chart is that when you're trying to take large sample, first the minimum and the maximum value are not that related at all, and also the range tends toward a constant, which would be the UCL minus the LCL value. If you take a very large number of sample, chances are that the minimum value you're going to take is going to be very close to the minimum value of the distribution, and the maximum will be on the other side. So really, you need to use the standard deviation chart if you want to take large sample or look over a long period of time. Those two charts, the R chart and the sigma chart, are really used in conjunction with the X bar chart. So if you want to look at both type of variation in the process, shift in the average, in the trend, or a constant trend but more or less variability in the process, you need to look at those charts side by side, because they're really giving you indication on different type of variation to your process.